Hello, Airbus cockpit coach here. You're joining me on the flight deck of the iniBuilds A350, and in this video we're going to look at the taxi in and shutdown procedures. So we've just come off runway 31 left at John F. Kennedy, New York, and we've vacated at Mike Charlie. So the first thing we want to do is make sure our spoilers are disarmed. We come up and we set our lights up here, so we'll have strobes to off. Landing light will come off and the nose wheel light comes to taxi. Then we set our EFIS, so we don't need traffic anymore, and the weather radar comes off. We turn on our airport navigation function. And we can zoom in on that to improve our situational awareness. At this point, we'd also turn the taxi camera on, although this is not modelled currently in the simulator. We'll then make sure we've got the flaps up. We'll start our APU. And we'll select anti-ice as required. Then come down and we complete the after landing checklist. Everything's been auto-sensed there, so checklist is complete. Gonna bring up the wheel page. Want to monitor brake temperatures. And I'm gonna release the parking brake now and begin our taxi in. Want to keep N1 values below 30% on the taxi, the same with the taxi out. Minutes after the use of high thrust, we can perform a single engine taxi, so we can shut down one engine. Approaching 30 knots there, so I'm going to apply a bit of brake now just to bring the speed back down. It's going to be one smooth application, and all we have to do for the single engine taxi in the A350 is close the master switch for the engine. On single engine, the A350 does taxi nicely. You do need to pay attention though to energy management in the turns, making sure you don't completely lose energy in the aircraft, as it can be very hard to get going again. In terms of brake temperatures, if we needed to use the brake fan, they're all low today, but if we needed to use the brake fan, we want to wait to at least 5 minutes after landing or turning that on. Allow the brakes to cool a little bit so we don't oxidise the brakes. Using the brake fan does mean that you can only depart with the brakes below 150 degrees rather than below 300, so that's a consideration on the turnaround. If you need to cross any runways during your taxi in, you want to turn the strobes back on while crossing the runway once cleared by traffic control. And generally we're keeping a good eye out at junctions, calling clear left side, clear right side as we taxi around. Just applying a little bit of thrust now so we don't lose energy And we're going to take the first left turn here. We are clear on the left, we are clear on the right. This is the 1000 variant, so it's very long. Keeping that thrust in. Tight turns, you definitely need a fair bit of thrust. So we're about to come on to understand here. Before we do that, we want to make sure the weather radar is off. We also want to turn the taxi light off so we don't blind any ground crew as we come in. Okay, stand is looking clear. I'm going to oversteer. Bit of thrust in. Okay, parking brake comes on. Next we want to turn the AP bleed on. And then we can shut down engine 1. We can turn the beacon light off and our seat belts once our N1 drops below 5%, so that's safe to approach the aircraft. The beacon comes off and the seatbelts now come off, so we release the cabin. Then we turn our fuel pumps off, and we do that in the order of right to left, so our standby pumps don't kick in. Then we come down to our surveillance page, and we make sure that the transponder's in standby. That's off. And then we bring up the parking checklist. Exterior lights are being set, we've got park brakes, we can set the shocks now as well, so we can go to our ground page here. We can select shocks and ground power. The parking brake is set and shocks are on, transponder is standby, checklist, parking checklist is complete. Once the ground power is available, you turn it on in the order of right to left. External 1, external 2 connected, and we can confirm on the electric page that we have those ground power sources available. Because we've got the APU running at the current moment, external 1 is not connected and being used because it defaults to the APU generator, as we discussed on some of the earlier videos. So at this point we'll be completing our logbooks for maintenance items, so we'll be checking ECAMs. We monitor the fuel as well, so we'll do a fuel check. And we want to check that the total fuel used plus the fuel on board equals our departing block fuel. And by that we can then identify if there's any leaks. We want to ensure equal fuel burn across the aircraft, and we check our tanks as well. So come onto the fuel page. Here to look at that information, so you'd have total fuel used at the, in the middle there. Check the balance of fuel usage as well. We'll also check our IRSs, so we'll come down to the init page, we'll go to position and monitor, and we can check deviation, our initial position, and they're all in line there and acceptable. If there was one that was way out, so that's something that we'd mark in our maintenance logbook, be checked out. Once we've done all that to secure the aircraft, we'll turn the ADIRs off. The APU bleed will come off, and the emergency exit lights will come off. We'd only do this side of the shutdown checks once the aircraft is empty of people and everyone's vacated. We'd put all our signs to off. The APU can come off, and all four batteries as required. Right to left. Off. And if we were to turn the taxi camera off, if we were to disconnect ground power now, the aircraft would go cold and dark. So we can go in the order of 1 and 2. There we go. That is how we shut down the aircraft once everybody is off. So I hope you enjoyed that series, the Airbus A350. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe to help the channel out. And I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.